Film Review, Movies, Music, Culture, Politics, Society Podcast, Interviews, Movie Reviews, and more. Live Sundays at 5:30 p.m. on Facebook at Crazon Dion.
Hey everybody, this is Lunell, the original bad girl of comedy. I'm here at the Link Promenade in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, and you're watching the Film Review.
We're here at Tracy D's web show, sitting right here with RZA from the Wu-Tang. All right, now, my boy, now, with all of your national, international popularity, right, is it today, is it about record sales or what you get when you come into this, when you go around the world and get this kind of love? Is it about record sales or is it about that love?
It's more about love and just a spread of the culture. Record sales, I sold 50 million records already. You know what I mean? So I never sold a record in my life.
And I want more people.
So that argument that we're hearing, so the argument that we're hearing is coming from out of the East now, because let's say the U.S. came up, the South came up, and now the Midwest coming up. That doesn't really pertain to necessarily.
Nah, I'm telling us because we are global icons. And I've been to places like Serbia. Serbia is like the Czechoslovakia and all these countries. We got 100,000 people. Those are Wu-Tang companies. You know what I mean? So we're global. But I will say this though, the reason why some artists complain is because not because they're not getting record sales, it's because the radio and the programmers always just stuck on one side of the map. You know what I mean? Because they stuck on the east and they stuck on the west, on the south. They never put it all together. And let everybody live. You know what I mean? That's a problem, because if you do what you're doing in Cleveland, or do what I'm doing in New York, you're doing what you're doing in Chicago, there's only 1,000 of us. Yeah, like a million of us, 1,000 of us. It's 100 million people. You should be able to spread that love to everybody. But the radio may have 10 niggas they choose out, and that 10 artists keep going back and forth, you know what I mean? That's a problem, because if you're in New York, you're like, yo, four artists from the south, four from Chicago, two from the west, where's New York at? You get two from the south, two from New York, two from Chicago, two from the Midwest, two from Europe, maybe. Maybe we got a better thing. Or maybe double it up, 20. You know what I mean? So that's the main problem. Yo.
Okay, so now, when you go over to the European country, do you find that the MCs, that they love you over there? Do you find that the people who do hip-hop have that edge where they want to compete with you?
Sells because the record sales come from, yo, none of these rappers sold more records than him. None of these rappers sold more records than Vanilla Ice.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And they can't even rap.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So record sales are not competition, homie. Word for word, your word that lives long. A word like I was in Vegas, and they'll kick it to me in the roulette table. He pulled one of my lyrics to the roulette guy. He's like, speak the truth, it takes bravery. That's a quote from the RZA. For him, it was gospel.
Right.
He was like, CB at the club. But he wasn't like, Jake and Jenna Juice. Those are big records. I love Jenna Juice. I love 50. But, you tell your boys, you can lose that shit in your life. It's prosthetic. You can take it with you. You can pull it anywhere you want. And the wisdom you get from us, you can use it again. You know, but like Marvin Gaye, what's going on?
Let's go back. Wu-Tang. In the 80s, in the mid-80s, up into the 90s, we had a college radio here in Cleveland. Did the Wu-Tang start out in college radio, or was it something where it came from the street that went to the mainstream?
No. the streets to college radio to mainstream. So would you say the college radio?
Oh, man.
The first place to ever play the Wu-Tang record on radio was a college radio station called PRP by a white guy named Greg Provis, named DJ G, and a guy out of Houston named Will Strickland from Texas. There was college radio DJs, and he put it to the Gavley book.
Gavley, yeah.
Exactly. And they're the first two guys that ever played my record on the radio. And they shared it with a few of their other friends. Like, yo, you heard this new thing, this particular song? You know, when you hear about it. And they all start talking about it. And it grew until about 3 months later. The first DJ that played on the mainstream radio was Kim Capri on WBLS.
Okay.
Now, how
does Afro Samurai Heat organize with 030 Bastard in his spirit? How was RZA
all of them together? Well, we have to talk on your website, on your people's. I don't keep us together. I tell you, it's more like the nine planets. Everybody got their own orbit. They all rotate around the sun in their own time, their own year, their own orbit. I sort of learned that I'm the seventh in the center of the sun. Me, I sit still. You know what I mean? And I love all my brothers. And my brothers are so powerful and great. And so, all of them is great. But I try to sit still. And when the time comes, they'll appear at my table, they will. But these are great scientists. These are all generals. We don't need each other. We don't need each other at all.
Real deep question. With the passions of all 30 bastards, did they regret it? Because on the DVDs, we would hear back and forth passing. Is there any regret for it?
Yeah. But the news already been, you know, it's like Ghostface said it best. It's like losing a leg. But a man got learned to walk without that one leg. You know what I mean? And we have learned. You know what I mean? But all these men were so important to us, it's almost detrimental. Hey, but ODB passed. What's somebody fast? So one day, like that. Not so much. I'm gonna pass one day. Everybody gonna pass. That's all of us gonna pass. So we'll take this forever. You know what I'm saying? That's forever, yo. Physically, we all gonna pass. You gonna pass just watching it. He gonna pass to go to interview. He younger than me, he gonna pass. You know what I'm saying? All bodies die. You know what I'm saying? Because it decays. Even the earth itself would decay one day. But it takes a long time, of course. So, losing ODB in the early phase of his life, it shocked me, and it took me back a few steps. But at the same time, it enlightened me, it inspired me. Because ODB was a man that was able to run around with a lot of women, and left a lot of children.
Yeah.
And one of his sons is known as Bar Son. His firstborn son is called Bar Son. His rap name is called Boy Jones.
Yes.
And he don't smoke. He don't drink. But I was promise you that he has the ODB spirit in him like nobody else.
Yes.
And he's about 18 going on 19 right there. And I'll put him up. I'm working right now to put a record out with him. And so having ODB was so great. ODB said there's no father to his style. There was no father to his style. But he's the father of many styles.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So Boss Up, Boy Jones. You do what you're doing, and go show the world what your father was talking about.
So, talking about college. Now, did you ever think in your wildest dream, the occasion that you would take this and then move into films and a cold acting job, the American Gangster? Especially the scene coming down the hallway when you were playing the junkie. That was tough. So, did you ever think that going from music, hip hop, would take you to this plateau now?
I gotta admit to you, honestly, I knew that Wu-Tang would inspire the world and influence the world. I really felt that in my heart. You watch my early documentary, you can see me saying it. You hear Jilla saying it. And Ray saying it. All of us saying the same thing in different interviews. Not even telling, I didn't tell me to say that. I didn't tell Jilla to say that. You knew that what we had was special. But for us to go into the film world, I think what happened for me was that in the day I first started hip hop, there was no DVDs. So in order for a guy to see a film in his car, you can listen to it. So 36 Chambers, Cuban Links, Liquid Swords, those are my movies. You know what I'm saying? That you can listen, that you can listen to. But now you got DVDs in your car with TVs, but it wasn't none of that in the old days. So I actually was ahead of the curve.
Okay.
And now I'm in the world I should be in with this film. This film is sound, light, and music. Bong bong.
So what's next for RZA?
Direct the movies.
That's it.
Okay.
I'd like to thank
RZA. Respect
Crazy D's web show.
Crazy D, what up?
And website?
My website? Very important. Yours is more important. My I'll sell websites. Watch out for my movie, The Man with the Iron Fist.
Crazy D's web show. Exclusive.
The Film Review. Movies, music, culture, politics, society, podcast, interviews, movie reviews, and more. Live Sundays at 5:30 p.m. on Facebook at Crazon Dion.
Hey, everybody, this is Lunel, the original bad girl of comedy. I'm here at the Link Promenade in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, and you're watching The Film Review.